Mary-Ann progresses in her work as if she were unrolling a path. But this is not a planned path when you know where it leads. She expresses it with a metaphor, tumbleweeds, or in French, virevoltant. In Russian, it's also a lovely word, perikatipole. The title of this exhibition makes you think a lot, a strange country. Well, I would like to talk about this word, strange, which is also the name of a philosophical method. Étrange, strange, to give, to show, to make you see things in a strange way, the things we all know and see.
Donc, il y a deux références. L'une, c'est la pensée de Ludwig Wittgenstein, et notamment ses jeux de langage.
We may thus refer to Ludwig Wittgenstein, in particular to his language games, but also to the concept of the Russian formalist school, for which the word strange really meant a method. Other words can be built on the word strange. Strangization, estrangement, making strange, or distanciation, defamiliarization. In Mary-Ann's work, there are different approaches, and also a continuity that has to do with looking at things again and again, coming back to our own path, but at the same time, reaching a new vision of things. But why should we think of Wittgenstein in the artist's studio, where we are surrounded by things in the true meaning of the word? Things made, organized, assembled, accumulated, painted, written, reversed, moved, framed, unframed, outframed, even scattered. Mary-Ann's purpose, indeed, is to find our own way to make things visible. At first sight, we might think that everything is light. You see this work in blue, gray, white. It's much easier to tell stories, to treat the work as a narrative. We, art critics, philosophers, love subjects. When we can deal with subjects, it provides a thread. Ah, here we are. This is the River Seine. This is a subject we can talk about. We can make references to. But what are we going to say of a painting when all you have are spots or something defragmented, when it is outframed? How can we discuss it, think it? For we always need a thread, a narrative, or a story. Allow me to quote Wittgenstein in his introduction to the philosophical investigations. My thoughts were soon crippled if I tried to force them on in any single direction. The same or almost the same points were always being approached afresh from different directions and new sketches made. I see much originality, singularity in what Mary-Ann creates. Here, in this picture, I see a landscape. But landscape means a lot of things, not only in the sense that it is a created landscape, a painted landscape we can recognize, but here the landscape is a way of entering into a relationship with space, with spatiality, and it is also a way of introducing the viewer to his own spatiality. It's no accident if the landscape appears in Mary-Ann's work, because what we can see here, and also in the video of some of her installations, is that she tends to place the viewer within her work.
donner à voir et donner cette
giving something to see, and giving the opportunity to touch with the eyes, setting a distance, a border, a limit between the viewer, the mirror, between what is watching and what is watching him, and giving another possibility to everything that is corporal. In Mary-Ann's sense, being able to really feel corporally, bodily, what is artistic, what pertains to art. Thus, in her work, art is not simply what is on the walls. The creative process overflows and goes, in this sense, more directly into the raw material.
Dans ce sens plus brut, dans le matériau. Le langage peut être.
Language games offer different types of expression, not only verbal, but gestures as well. I think the word gesture is also very important to Mary-Ann, who goes from a language game to another, playing with balls, with snow, with rain, or with tears, and even with monoprinting. Then, what interests me is how one sight is translated into various forms of perception. Therefore, how the work of the artist here can be compared to the passage, the transition from eye to ear, to a bodily feeling, a sensation, or to an aspect change, to quote Wittgenstein. And at the same time, through such a passage, we recognize again and again what is familiar, what we may have already seen, but see now for the first time. Because looking and seeing are two different processes. Strangization, in a way, translates the Russian word ostranéyine. With this word, we want to express the act of coming back and again to a subject, a fact, a feeling, an object, from another point of view, to extract it from its usual surroundings, context, with a new eye, and thus to make this word, this form of expression, this thing, quite important word for the Russian formalist school, in order to transform this thing into an object of our own wonder, and through such wonder to reach poetry, to reach everything that is poetic in the sense of the Russian formalists.
La poésie, on y trouve tout ce qui est poétique dans le sens de l'école formaliste russe. Dans son œuvre, il y a ce travail entre différentes formes de perception.
In her work, different ways of perceptions are at stake because of the raw materials like slate, steel, lead, that she introduces and makes us see differently. A strange country. This is a journey through a strange country.
C'est un voyage dans un étrange pays. Il y a encore une
chose. In order to reach a new vision, the way the Russian formalists meant it, you need an obstacle. That is, not saying everything. To destaticize things. To destaticize language. This means that there is always something coming in our way, making a shift, throwing us out of the frame. When I look very carefully at Mary-Ann's out-frame framings, my brain feels a slight distortion. Is the angle wrong? Is it the frame or the wall? You don't notice it at once, but you can feel something. Something is slightly out-framed. It is an obstacle done in such a way that it takes us into a poetic space. To finish, I would like to add a few words about a very important notion to the Russian formalists, the notion of factur, factura, which means texture, grain, material. And in this sense, Mary-Ann has done a lot of work. Here, regarding the texture, we get ready to feel, to find a way to feel bodily what will afterwards always remain in our vision, in our memory. So, I invite you to discover this strange country of Mary-Ann's. Thank you.
Merci.